G'day guys and girls, how you going? It's your boy Jamble1990 and welcome to episode 1 of DayZ. So guys, we're here on a DayZ server. This is actually a mod of a mod, I guess you could say, or a different type of variation on the mod of the DayZ from Arma 2. This is not the standalone, this is the original DayZ, but this is the map Panthera. And we are on a server called Bonfire, so if any of you guys want to come check it out, you can. We've just spawned in. I did play on this server for about an hour, and I broke my leg, and I had to crawl around everywhere, so I lost a lot of good stuff. I just let some zombies kill me. I have no idea about this map. I have no idea where I am. I have no idea where to go. So this is going to be kind of like a noob let's play. It's going to take quite a while for me to record, just simply for the fact that I'm going to cut out boring stuff. But I kind of just wanted to do it from scratch so I can show you guys what to do as well, if any of you guys are interested. So in this server, you join in with basic, really, really basic stuff. No weapons. You get a backpack, which is really, really nice. No map, no nothing. Is that a zombie up there already? I must be near a town then. And you pretty much, the first thing you need to do, essentially, you need to try to find yourself a town or somewhere that you need to be able to get some weapons from. So you can see in the chat, these guys are talking about this server's being PvE, which is pretty cool. Did he hear me already? Is he coming at me? Hope he's not. I'll show you guys some basic tips and stuff on what to do when you first start off, especially if a zombie detects you, which I think this one's done. I think he's detected me. A lot of people die from zombies when they first join, and there's actually really easy ways to avoid these guys. Is that more up there? No, they're just bushes and shrubs and stuff. Cool. So, basic commands and stuff I won't really go through because it's kind of boring and it's very basic. So, if you don't know the basics and you kind of just need to go to YouTube and watch the basic tutorials video, I wouldn't really be the best at explaining that stuff anyway. But apparently, this map and these type of servers with this mod, the Panthera mod, Epoch, the mod is Epoch. What the fuck is that? Is that a dog? Is that a puppy? Come back here, puppy. Unless you're a zombie puppy. Looks like a dog. So these episodes are going to go for about 30 minutes long each. They are going to go for quite a while. Is this a dog? Hello, puppy. Please don't be bad. Oh, look at the puppy. Hello. Is he trying to attack me? No, he's not. Hello, puppy. You're a cute little boy, aren't you? So apparently on this mod with the Epoch mod, you can, which is what a lot of you guys recommended to me, which is pretty cool, by the way. Thank you guys for that. You can build bases and stuff. Oh, I can hear a vehicle. I can hear a vehicle. Or is that a plane or something? Sounds like a plane. It's a plane. Come on, run. Oh, God. This may be very good or very bad. Just want to make sure I'm in direct chat. In case I need to talk to these guys. Oh, shit. I need gunshots. Run, dude. Come on. Can you guys hear that? Where are these guys? Did sound like it was coming up. Oh, look. Over there. There's a plane over there. Who's shooting? Is that him down there? Where is this guy? I can hear a vehicle. Sounds like he's... Is that the plane he's trying to set up? I wouldn't believe that if it is. It sounds like the plane. I think it is. I don't know if he realizes that it's face down in the dirt and he can't really do too much with it. unless there's one like right beneath me or something. I can't really see anything beneath me. I'm sure it has to be that one. Is there anyone over there? There looks like it's another shrub and a zombie down that way. Interesting. I have no idea how that plane got there. If that was a spawn in, then that's a pretty interesting. Let's see if this is the guy on the plane. I'd kind of want to talk in chat, but then I don't really want to in case these guys are hostile. It's never really good to deal with people who are hostile. Unless this guy's legitimately stuck. Oh, there's a town down there. Okay. I kind of just really want to watch this plane, though, because I don't know who's over there. And that zombie. Is that a zombie or a player? I think that's a player. If that's a player, then he can see me up here. No, that's a zombie. Why was he aggroed then? I'm so confused right now. I mean, we don't really have anything to lose. We've just spawned in. He needs a hatchet. This guy's probably only just spawned in, so I guess we can just take a chance and see. Oh, there's another plane down there. Right, okay. So I think that's the guy who needs help. Might be Aaron Westham. He's running around. He's just still just chilling in the plane. Those zombies are kind of just sitting there. I just want to ask him. I'm kind of very exposed here too, which is really not good. But I kind of don't want to waste any time. I kind of just want to see if this guy's friendly or not. I see movement up there. To the left. I can hear another vehicle. Okay, so it is this guy. Let's go see if we can come down and talk to this guy. I don't think he's even noticed me yet. I can't even see where he is. Okay, cool. This guy's friendly. Let's go to direct chat and we'll see if we can talk to this guy. So yeah, guys, the first thing you always really need to do and make sure of is that whatever server that you're on is either going to be PvE, which is just players versus entities, which is zombies in this game, or PvP, which is player versus player. You near the bandit airport? No, he's not. This is not an airport. This is in the middle of nowhere. Hey, zombie. We're kind of in a bad spot for zombies too, because I was going to talk earlier about a chat. Wait, this may not be this guy. Is that? I'm a bit worried about these zombies. I think that guy's just kind of chilling in the airplane. Let's see if he can hear me. Hey, dude, can you hear me down there? You in the airplane down there? Talk in direct chat if you can. This poor guy is like surrounded by some zombies. And there's no real good way to get out of there. Don't know how he got in there. Can you hear me, man? There's a restart in 15 minutes. Dang, that's not going to be too good. But so the very first thing you need to do in DayZ ever is find yourself some food and a weapon. A weapon is probably the most important thing you need to do. Kind of really want to head down this way, but there's a lot of zombies and this is a bad, bad spot. I can't see that guy inside. And these zombies are kind of just sitting there, so I'm going to kind of guess that he's inside. Oh, my caps is on. Can't see him in there. My render distance isn't that great. But those zombies are just sitting there, and I could hear a plane. It's not that one, because I couldn't see that moving. Okay, so this guy's just found a random plane. Hope that zombie didn't just hear me. Wherever he was. Oh, God, okay. Aggro zombies. This guy's kind of in a bad spot, so I guess what I should do is just try to get him to get out of the plane and follow me. And we're going to make a break for the city. And we'll see if this guy can hear me. Can you hear me now, man? I'm talking in direct chat. Follow me, dude. Follow me. Run and just don't stop. You're just gonna follow me, okay? Come on, let's come this way. Just make a run for it and let's just don't stop. We don't want these zombies to catch us. So it looks like we just found ourselves a friend who's bleeding.
Yeah.
So can you hear me now, dude?
Yeah.
You do know you're bleeding, alright?
Yeah, I'll stop bleeding eventually.
Okay. Alright, let's just get ahead of these zombies and, actually, just stop now. You can bandage. I'll distract these zombies. Do it real quick. And you don't want to get hit by zombies, guys, so you always just kind of want to just be moving around really quick and just don't let zombies try to get the upper hand on you.
Yeah, I'm good.
Alright, let's go. Let's go straight towards the town. We're going to want to try to get there as soon as we can to try to get rid of these zombies. So, yep, there's two real main ways you can get rid of zombies, guys, and that's by running through trees, which there's no proper ones here. Bushes and towns, like houses and stuff like that. Now, we're going to be in a little bit of a tight spot here because there's going to be zombies spawning ahead of us because we are heading into a town. And if there's no weapons in here, we're going to be in a lot of trouble. Let's head into this barn to the left here and see if there's a weapon, because we're going to be in a bit of trouble if there's not. And we'll see how we go with this. I mean,
yeah,
you guys can't say I faked this. Usually there's always weapons in barns, so that's going to be a plus. I think that guy just said he found a gun. What's this? Oh, found some bullets. Take some M1 mags. Most servers usually let you spawn in with a gun, but this one doesn't, so that's a shame. There's not too much you can do about it. What the heck is that? What is that? Gear. A Makarov mag. Okay, so any ammunition and stuff you find, it's always worth picking it up and checking it out. Is there a zombie over there? No, it's him. So how you going, dude? Did you just spawn in as well? Your new spawn?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too.
I don't really know the map. It's the first time I've played this mod.
Yeah, me too, man. I'm actually, I'm recording right now, so I hope you don't mind, like, because I've been putting this up on YouTube. So I hope you don't mind that.
Oh, okay.
And we need to really try to find some weapons. And I have no idea what this map is like, so if we're near an airfield, that'd be awesome. But we kind of just need to scope it out. Oh, wait. This might be near where I died before. Just look around, man. Have a look at weapons.
We're near a airfield. The bandit one.
Oh, the bandit one. It's no good.
We go back to the CS and it has a GPS and we can see how far out it is.
Do you have one?
Oh, I don't have a map, but if we go to the CS and it has a GPS built, so we can go to it.
Oh, okay. Probably just best off just maybe looking on foot first. There's some binoculars there. Ooh. Oh god. So Mort just killed Cool Frog. Looks like we have a bandit on the server. there's two main types of ways you can play DayZ, guys. The first one being a bandit, which is you just pretty much just kill everyone on site, which is probably the worst way to go. Ooh, the Enfield mag. It might be worth taking that, actually. And a hero, which is kind of just wanting to just be a nice person and helping people out as much as you can. Do you know which way the airfield is? Like, if it's north, south, east, west, or anything like that?
Hold on, if we go back to the CS, we can find out.
Yeah, alright, let's do that. Okay, so we are at plane number 2. That doesn't really look like it's doing too well. I want to try to get the gear. Whenever you see planes like this, guys, it's probably my advice not to try to get into it, because there we go, gear. Dang it, nothing in it. DayZ can be very, very buggy, and if you try to touch planes and stuff like this, it does have the very potential to kill you. Just squish you and mess you up quite badly. So I think this guy is either going to do the smart thing.
Hey, look, we're 600 meters away from an airfield in this direction.
Awesome. Yeah, I thought it might be down the town way, so that's cool. We may as well make our way down there. So we're going to make our way down there. We're just going to go through the town and try to make our way through the airfield. What the fuck is that? That's a zombie. Okay. I see. I don't want to always try to avoid zombies at all costs, especially when you first spawn in, because they can kill you, and it's really, really super annoying. But thankfully, we're human beings, and we can outsmart these guys. And that's what we really want to try to do. So hopefully Mr. Friendly Aaron here can kind of help me team up and maybe try to take out this bandit guy, whose name is Mort. Kind of ironic, giving the reference to Family Guy there. So, Oop, the where? Oh, the airfield's just here, so you might have to be really careful here, dude. Just saying, there was a bandit who killed someone on site just before, so just keep your eyes out. We always just really always want to make sure of other players. I think that's a training outpost down there. I think that's a safe area. So if we start getting shot at, we can always head down in there just to, you know, bandits are bandits. They're never going to really change their minds. And if you start getting shot on site, then you're going to die. But sometimes you have the luxury of having servers like this with little safe zones that you can actually get into, which kind of stop bandits from killing you on site, which is always a plus. But it's it's tricky at the same time. So this is a big cargo ship. Yeah, this is the trading center, which isn't very of much use. So this won't have any gear in it, man. This is the trading center.
Shit.
So we want to go down the other end, which is probably what we do want to do. And I'm really hoping that this Mr. Bandit isn't around this end. So what I think I'm going to do is kind of just lay back a little bit, because this guy is just kind of just running in mindlessly. I might wait around and just try to come back after the server restart, and we want to try to get ourselves a weapon. So I'm just going to head amongst this tree line up towards the... I'm going to guess this is heading north or east. The eastern side of the airstrip. Hopefully try to see if we can scout out any bandits. If there's anyone around, and see how we go from there. But yeah, I'll be right back in a sec, guys. Alrighty, guys, so the server has restarted, and I don't really like these type of situations when server restarts. Well, there's a bike up there, and there's a car over there. When the server restarts, and like I haven't been on for a couple of hours, I just decided to come back in. You don't know where people are, so you kind of just got to scope it out. That's probably another tip that I will give to you guys. Like, you guys don't have to follow my rules or tips or anything. It's just kind of just the way I do it is that I always like to just sit and wait for a little bit before just blindly running in somewhere. And I've been watching this place. I only just noticed the vehicles because it's too far away to see them, but I haven't seen any players around here in a while, so we're just going to take the chance. I mean, we've got nothing to lose anyway. There's no zombies down there either, which is what's also telling me that there's no players. No zombies equals no players, because zombies only spawn A in towns like this or wherever there's structure. Not necessarily towns, but whenever there's buildings, and when the zombies about where, if like, see that zombie just spawned in, so there's probably going to be zombies spawning in all over the place now. So if you ever see zombies and you're really far away, it means that there's people kind of near where you are. I don't know why my character's doing this derpiness, and that zombie's already spotted me. So another little tip, guys. So say, look, this zombie spotted me, right? If you want to get zombies off your ass, I'm going to have quite a few following me now. But all you have to do is try not to let them hit you and come into a building like this. Buildings like these are perfect. If you run into buildings, I don't know why I'm not sprinting or anything. Is that a knife? What's a mag? Zombies can't actually run indoors, so I'm just going to take that and move away from these zombies. Zombies actually can't run indoors, so you can see how these guys are kind of just, look, they're just chilling. So you can actually evade zombies. I don't know why I'm not doing the normal... Oh, there we go. You can actually evade zombies by moving into buildings and stuff like this by just simply just running inside. So we want to try to take as much ammo and stuff as we can, because it's going to be pretty handy. We want to actually put this. I hate that. You guys can hear that. I only did it once, thank God. There's a church just on the inside part of this town. So what we want to try to do is try to get some weapons, and we always just need to be really mindful of other players, but we also want to check vehicles and stuff like that too. So I want to check this bike, see if it's working, because vehicles are always very, very helpful. And this bike is working. It is actually working. That's good. So let's just ride this thing up. Oh my God, it's extremely slow. Okay. May as well just, we may as well just not even worry about that. We can check the gear in it. I don't think there's going to be anything in here. Not because it was freshly spawned. There was no one around here, so we just want to continuously check these. There's fuel in there. There's a tire. So basically what you need to do, what you need to try to do in DayZ is just gather yourself some weapons. Those zombies are following me. Gather yourself some weapons, and then also gather yourself some food. Food and stuff is very, very, very important, especially when you first start off, and I don't actually have any food. What's this? Looks like more ammunition. Yep, more ammunition. Man, if anyone kills me, they're just gonna get like an entire armory full of ammo. The zombies just here. Sounds like quite a lot of them though. Do you wanna go check that car out too? That's gonna be awesome if that works. So let's just make a break for it. These zombies can follow us if they want. Oh god, please don't hit me. Run, you yobbo. So, even though this looks like a very bad situation where I have zombies coming at me all over the place, if you find cars like this that work, fingers crossed it's gonna work. Does it have tires on it? Nope, it doesn't. That is a damn shame. So, what you need to try to do is lose some zombies. I'm hoping there's no players around that are just gonna kinda scope me out. But see, I've got like 10 zombies behind me right now. A lot of people just freak out and be like, you know, that's how they get killed. If you find houses like these, which do have some loots in them, but I'm not going to be able to loot them at the moment with all these zombies on me, run through them. Run directly straight through them. So what you want to do is run and then slow down a little bit. There's another zombie through here, so I'm going to have to run past him. And those zombies now are going to get stuck in that house, and they're going to slow right down. So now if we just come through this house, we'll quickly actually have a really quick look in here. Oh, look at that. Canteen. Water bottles. We only need one. Now we need to make a break for this too. Oh, what's that? Is that clothing? Why can't I get that? Open compact pack. Nothing in there. So let's just keep moving. There's zombies coming now. So if we just chill out for a little bit. Maybe those zombies haven't detected us. And that's another way you can lose zombies, guys. So just a little tip for you. You ever wondering how to avoid some zombies? That's a way to do it. So we do actually want to check these barracks. We do just want to try to find a pistol or something. Something that we can use. Haven't seen any zombies yet, so... I can hear them, though. They're in that building. So, see, I've lost those zombies already. Oh, there's another one down there. So, it's a bit unfortunate those vehicles aren't working, but, that motorbike does need a little bit of repairing, but I didn't actually see anything around that we can repair it with, which is a shame. So, we just need to keep looking. I can hear a zombie very close. Very, very close. Why aren't you going through this? What on earth? It's gonna say, please don't be at the door. They're coming that way. I can hear them. They're just in... Oh my god. Okay, let's see if we can go this way. Don't know why my character's not wanting to run through here. Please don't break my leg. Oh god. Okay, we're out. Good. Okay. Okay, so, another little tip on the Epoch servers. I'm not too sure about all of them, but I know this one specifically. Zombies can climb stairs and ladders, so you do have to be very careful. Usually when you think on normal DayZ servers that places like this are very safe and usable, just remember that... What the fuck is that? Flashlight. Okay, I'll take that. Just remember that these zombies in this server, on this mod, can climb ladders, so zombies are going to be coming up that way, and there's a ladder just over there to the left, so. We kind of just need to... There's an empty whiskey bottle. Usually there's weapons in here, which is disappointing. That's what I was hoping for. Wait, what the heck? More ammunition. Man, we've got more ammo than we can handle right now. If we could throw bullets as fast as guns could shoot them, these zombies would be in trouble. Okay, so these guys are kind of just chilling there. Have a look at that, guys. They're coming for me. I don't know if they still detect me or not. Hopefully they don't. Because we do want to try to choose a direction. I think we're going to head that way. Into another town. I think that's where the church is. Yeah, you can see the church. See the gold bell that's on the left-hand side there? That's right in the middle. That's what the churches look like. So we do want to kind of go towards the church. Let's get down this ladder before these zombies can kind of find us. There we go. They're coming up. They sound like they're coming up the stairs. So yeah, we're going to run into the bushes over that way. Try to make these zombies despawn, because not only if you're close enough, zombies will spawn near where you are. If you run further enough away, they also will despawn. I think they've heard me. We'll see. So yeah, if you run far enough away from zombies, that's what vehicles are really good for. You can actually make them despawn as well. Good. The zombies didn't hear me. Hey, puppy. Hello. This guy did, though. Hey, buddy. What's up? You can't actually even get through these fences, either. I have to go back around. I want to try to find a pine bush. Like, oh, God. Run. I actually want to try to find a pine tree or something where I can show you how you can lose these guys, because this guy might actually follow me for quite a while. But trees like this that don't have really have good branches and stuff on them, they're not really good for much. So this guy's going to stay on my butt for a while. So I just want to try to lose him. Okay, guys, so we lost our little zombie friend. And as you can see, or you may have just seen right there as I started talking down the bottom right-hand side of the screen. Well, there's a truck over there. That we just entered another town. So I did lose that zombie just by running. I didn't even get to find a bush to actually hide out in. I just ran through trees and zigzagged and confused the hell out of him. So the main thing you want to try to do, I really hope that I can kind of demonstrate this well in this video, is find yourself a good source of supplies, which are usually in towns. What's that over there? Thought I seen another vehicle through the bushes. Nope. So you do want to try to find a good source of supplies. Look at that glitch. That glitchy glitch. But also, running through towns like this is really difficult without a vehicle or food or weapon because, like, look at that. See those zombies that are in the middle of the street? Not going to be a good idea to go there. So I kind of just want to flank around these bushes, hopefully avoid being detected by zombies, and try to, fingers crossed and pray to God that this truck is fully working so we can get the hell out of there. Come on, truck, be good to me. What on earth? Never mind. So, is it the Yuri? Get in the driver's seat. Come on, buddy. The wheels are a little bit damaged. I think it's the back left one there. But it still looks drivable, so let's just try to see if it'll start. Nope. Nope, that's not a good sound. That is not a good sound. Whenever you hear vehicles like crunching and glitching and being all weird, never usually a good sound. And also, trying to start that up and while there's being a lot of zombies around, also not a good idea. Aha! Also a very good thing to find is some soda. Any form of drink or food that you find, you need to be able to take. So I just found my very first supply of a type of food, I guess. You know, it's a liquid. We can use it to refuel. And the reason why I'm being extremely stealthy through this little house is because we're in the heart of the... Oh, what was that? Painkillers. It can never hurt to have too many painkillers. More slugs. We don't need more weapons. Oh, look, a gun. Yes. So we've now got our first weapon. This is what I'm talking about, guys. My guy wants to stop glitching out. There we go. Got ourselves a revolver. Always make sure to reload it. Sometimes they don't come automatically loaded, so that's a good thing to always do that. We just still want to be very stealthy because there's a lot of zombies around, and a revolver with 6 bullets is still not going to do it. So we've looked around for some vehicles, haven't found any just yet. There's another. Oh, look at this! Look at this! Doesn't have any ammo, but it does have a Sega, which is a very nice weapon. Let's have a look at it. I'll show you guys what the Sega looks like. This is what the Sega looks like. Looks awesome. Just turn around, have a look at it. Look at that. Schmexy. So it's a semi-automatic SMG. It's not going to be very good without any ammunition, but still a very good find. Now, let's actually have a look to see if in our backpack any of the ammunition that we found. You want to have a look at the gun, and you can see that it says 12 gauge caliber. From memory, I can actually remember that we actually have quite a few slugs. Wait, are those slugs back downstairs? Are we going to be able to use them? Let's have a look. I thought we already picked up slugs. That's what I was having a look at my backpack for. Apparently not. Okay. So let's see if these slugs that are downstairs... Hopefully there's no zombies just outside the door. Let's see if we can take these. Yeah. Give me those slugs. Let's see if we can combine the two. Nope, it's not going to work. Can't even load it up into the gun. Interesting. So I thought they were 12 gauges. Let me have a look. They are... Yeah, they are 12 gauge. Caliber 2. So I'll kind of load... Let's actually try to see if we pull out the gun and hit reload. Nah, still not going to work. So these slugs, for some reason, aren't really compatible, which kind of sucks. But still, we're on our way, guys. We've got ourselves a gun now. Just what we want. Oh my god, that bell. Perfect way to attract zombies. Oh, there's more here too, look. We need to try to figure out a way to get these to work. And you get in my... There we go, okay. Combined to 8 round. Still not gonna work. God dang it. Okay, so, rearm. Not too sure why it's not gonna work in this, there you go. A semi-automatic shotgun, 12 gauge. I thought that was the SMG, I'm sorry. So, 12 gauge. Used in the M1014. That's kind of unfortunate, but I mean, like I said, guys, we've got ourselves a gun now. So that's all that matters. We just want to rummage around for anything else and see what we can find before heading off. So this is a perfect example of what I was talking to you about, guys. Right now, I have a zombie hot on my tail and I decided to hide in a bush. Actually, I'm just hiding in a bush right now. And you can see that this zombie is trying to attack me as much as he can, but he can't actually physically hit me. This is a little glitch that Daisy has with bushes, which I actually really like because, especially for the person who's just joining DayZ, this can be really hard to survive with. So if you ever get a zombie that's just like this and trying to attack you in a bush, they will get tired of it eventually, give up, and then just walk away. And you can't die. Yeah, that's right. You walk away.
Yeah, well, I doubt they'll have a hard time to decide once you hear my story. I saved them from the dark objective I am responsible for.
Nice try, buddy, but I've made up.